Hallo und herzlich willkommen auf Epic. Wir sind hier auf der SHOT Show 2020 am Stand von Busch Protective. Busch Protective ist ein deutsches Unternehmen, sehr interessante Helme, die jetzt auch in der Ausschreibung vom FBI und vom DEA ausgewählt worden sind. Ich bin hier mit Scott. Scott wird euch jetzt mal einen kurzen Überblick über die Helme geben. Scott, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So, give us a short overview over the helmets.
Excellent. So, Busch Protective has been making helmets for decades, but we really focus on being a law enforcement helmet provider. Whereas historically, most helmet manufacturers came out of the military, and they were focusing on stopping fragmentation, we decided that we wanted to create a helmet system that was focused on close quarters combat, small millimeter projectiles, 9mm, 40-45 fragmentation, but something that was truly designed for the law enforcement officer. So our helmet systems are, one of the key features is, they're all modular. So our helmet systems are built to be a unisize. So for example, this right here is our AMP-1 TP. This is our flagship helmet. This has been created in multiple cuts. So for example, if you look at this, this is our mid-cut helmet. We also have a full cut that has additional features. And then an example here is this is a high cut. So depending on the mission. And so what we've tried to do is we've tried to create ballistic helmet systems that are specifically catered towards the mission that each individual law enforcement officer, whether it's patrol, an active shooter situation, or perhaps a SWAT team, SEK, GSG-9, FBI, etc. So features of the AMP-1TP, what you've got here, we have our built-in rail system so that you can use torches, flashlights, infrared strobes. We also have additional accessories that can work with this as an entire system. So what's unique to our system that we created was a click-in visor system. So we have the ability to take a visor and in the field, while the officer still has the helmet on the system, is able to click in a visor and give additional protection in the moment.
So you don't have to take the helmet off, you can click everything in?
You do not have to take the helmet off, yeah. So, and in a lot of operations, they don't have time to take the helmet off. So the visor can be sitting on a clip on the pouch, and in one moment the visor can come on, click it in with one hand, and then they can go. We also have the ability using, because we use the click-in visor mount, you don't lose the real estate on the rails. You also have multiple points here for infrared strobes, for flashlights, torches, so it tends to be very modular. If you look at the actual construction of the helmet, another unique feature is that we have a wheel dial system that truly is a one-size-fits-all. So this helmet system will fit an officer everything from extra small all the way up to extra large. So this allows you to have a single helmet in a vehicle that multiple officers can use, or each officer can have their own helmet that they individually customize. Our pad systems are designed for, we've got dual pad systems. We have an energy absorbing pad system, that we also have a comfort pad system. Because obviously you're going to be wearing this for numerous hours, you want to be comfortable. Within this, our harness system is also adjustable. We've got 4 points on the adjustment so that you can adjust it here, here. So you've got 4 points around the harness, and then obviously you can ratchet it that way. The most important feature of this helmet is the protection.
Yeah.
So the AMP-1TP helmet was the first Aramid helmet designed to the VPAM-3 standard. So not only can this protect against up to the VPAM level, of course we stopped the NIJ protection level, which is relatively simple, but we also worked in conjunction in the United States with the Department of Justice. And the Department of Justice created a new helmet protocol. It's called the DEA FBI Helmet Protocol 2019. And this helmet is the only helmet in the world that satisfies that protocol.
Okay.
And the difference is, if you take a VPAM helmet, it satisfies all the VPAM, but the DEA also shoots the helmet within 25 millimeters from the edge. Obviously, that's a very hard standard. They shoot on the bolts, so the bolts are actually ballistic. They shoot on the shroud. They shoot in the back, the top, and they test a total of 8 helmets. Those 8 helmets, they shoot it a total of 44 times, and each of those 44 shots is a different test.
Wow.
They chill the helmet down to minus 40, and they actually increase the temperature to 140. They shoot it under both scenarios. Yeah. So basically, this helmet is designed to be able to support an officer in any environment, anywhere in the United States, and in theory, anywhere in the world. So the TP system, this obviously has our optional Velcro kit. We also have custom-made helmet covers that can be applied on there in various colors. A lot of officers like to put the IR strobes, flashlights. Our helmet systems also do work with the Peltor ear systems. So it's quite a modular system. And obviously we have a Wilcox shroud here. We have various shroud options. So ultimately this can be created any way you like. And then this is our ballistic mandible. This ballistic mandible can also work with a visor at the same time. This ballistic mandible will stop a 9mm round and up to the Stenag 2920 fragmentation. So it just gives that additional protection. So that's the MP1 TP.
And for the click in for the mandible, you also can click in on a gas mask, right?
Absolutely.
So
what you can do is this simply can click out, can easily come out, and then the mandible can removed, but it can come off. But also you can click in right here. You can click in the Avon gas mask, so you can wear them in conjunction with the visors and the gas mask.
Great, perfect. Yeah. So I will just do a short German wrap up. I don't get everything, but so für euch nochmal ganz kurz in Deutsch, um mal die wesentlichen Stichpunkte zusammenzufassen. Es war jetzt ja sehr, sehr viel Information. Wir packen euch das aber alles auch nochmal in den Blogbeitrag, da könnt ihr es nochmal nachlesen. Ballistischer Schutzhelm, Schutzklasse VPAM 3, ist einer der wenigen Helme, der wirklich eine sehr, sehr hohe Schutzklasse erfüllt. Die DEA und FBI hatte da im Fokus auch, dass der wirklich beim Beschuss auch hier an den Seitenbereich geschossen wird, auf die Schrauben geschossen wird, vorne auf die Schraut geschossen wird, also wirklich einen sehr, sehr hohen Schutzbedarf hat. Was auch sehr, ja, nicht unique ist, was unique, the word, I don't know the word for unique, the German word. Einmalig, danke Stefan, wieder. Die Switcherei zwischen Englisch und Deutsch ist manchmal sehr schwierig. Ja, also was einmalig ist, ist auch, dass es hier ein One-Size-Helmet ist. Also die Beschaffung ist viel einfacher, weil man keine Größen braucht. Von S bis XL hat man hier mit den Einstellungen wirklich in einer einzigen Größe. Ja? Dann habt ihr noch gesehen, für vorne, für die Front, das Mandible, was man dran machen kann. Das ist hier an der neuen Rail, die hier an dem Helm angebracht ist. Die ist sehr modular. Man kann da verschiedene Module anbringen. Das ist keine Kopie von irgendwas, sondern eine Eigenentwicklung. Das heißt, das Mandible wird einfach unten eingeklickt, kann ich abnehmen, kann eine Gasmaske dafür einsetzen, kann noch hier die Face Shields, die Schutzschilder für vorne in verschiedenen Stärkeklassen einbauen. Also wirklich ein sehr modularer Helm. Ich denke, ich habe alles, Stefan, oder? Gut. Ja, Busch Protective, super interessant. Ich blende euch den Link unten ein. Wenn ihr noch Fragen zu dem Produkt habt, schreibt es in die Kommentare. Wenn euch das Video gefallen hat, lasst ein Like da, abonniert den Kanal, denkt daran, die Glocke zu klicken und dann sehen wir uns beim nächsten Mal. Bis dann, macht's gut, bye bye. Thank you, Scott.
Thank you, appreciate it.